1096.
I'm going to give you guys a shout out when I talk. That's something. You got to know, that says a lot. That's typical Marine Corps, though. Marines will get up at 4 or 5 in the morning. Do anything.
Well, I tell you what.
I don't say reformer Marine. It's Marines.
Yes, sir.
For me, it's we're all Marines, so.
Well, Amos, when he was Commandant, gave a general order. He said, there's no former Marines. It's Marines of a different...
I correct people. I tell them all the time. I've met guys that said, hey, it's not a retired Marine, it's not a former Marine, it's a Marine.
Thank you.
meet in Farmville. And what a great day to celebrate another victory for General Allen Hal Turnage.
Yes.
Welcome to everyone here from out of town, especially to those from the military and to those from Raleigh who are here today. We will start our ceremony in a moment with the United States Marine Corps of Color Guard from I&I Reserve Unit out of Raleigh, North Carolina. Sergeants Proctor and Sergeants McCord, Corporal Jacobs, and Corporal Truel. After the presentation of colors, our mayor will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, and the 2nd Marine Aircraft Wing Band will lead us in singing of our national anthem. Then the Reverend Stuart and Lee will have our invocation, and then our speakers. We do thank everyone for being here, and we'll start our ceremony.
States of America, to the Republic for which it stands, the nation, God, liberty, and justice.
Together. We also give you thanks for our nation, founded in the heritage of men who laid their lives on the line for the freedom that they cared for and wanted, for their bravery, for their courage and their boldness. We are thankful. Men like Washington, Adams, Jefferson, and Lincoln, all who gave so much of their time for the founding of this country and the people that we shall become. We salute again General Turnage this day for his bravery and his goodness and his leadership and command as he led those men years ago. May this marker be an inspiration to the youth of this community that one man stood out and made a difference in the freedom of this nation. We give you thanks, O Lord, this day for this gathering and for Hal's life. Amen.
We want to welcome all of you, but some people we want to recognize individually. Congressman Walter Jones, who will be our speaker, one of our speakers. Deputy Secretary for the Department of Cultural Resources, Kevin Cherry. Jack Lewis, retired judge with the North Carolina Court of Appeals. Sergeant Major Paul Berry is here. He is the Sergeant Major, I'm going to get it wrong, he's at Marine Corps Base Camp Lejeune now, rather than Lejeune, I think. And his aide. The Color Guard, who did such a wonderful job presenting the colors to us. The band, we've already enjoyed. We've asked them to move into the shade, but they're Marines, and so they're toughing it out in the sun. The Marine Corps League is very well represented. Hopefully I'm not going to miss any of the detachments. We have members from the Department of North Carolina, which I understand is the overall league governing body, maybe. I'm not sure if that's right. We have members of the Down East Detachment, the General Allen Hal Turnage Detachment from Salisbury, and the Corporal Susie Sanis Detachment from Rocky Mount. I hope I got everyone, I'm not sure, from the Marine Corps League. Etsil Mason, Mayor of Farmville, Bobby Evans, the former Mayor of Farmville, is here. Town Commissioners, I know that I saw John Baker, Richard Hicks, and John Moore. I'm hoping Jamin Dixon and David Shackelford are also here. And if I didn't see you, I apologize, but there are a group of five that governs it. So. Beth Ward is here with the Pitt County Commission. Michael Hill, who is the retiring administrator for the North Carolina Highway Historical Marker Program, but he tells me he's not actually retiring. He's just turned his duties over to the lovely Ansley Wegner, who is also here, and they brought the photographer for North Carolina Archives, Linda Fox. Members of the family. I know we've had more members of the family actually join us, and we're delighted. I'm going to mention those closest members that I was aware of. Harvey Turnage, who is General Turnage's nephew, and his wife Janice, and their daughter, excuse me for reading, I don't remember all these names, Patricia Turnage Calloway. Then we have General Turnage's niece, Betty Lou Turnage Howard, and her daughter, Cindy Howard Canning. We have Mr. B.S. Smith, who is General Turnage's first cousin, and his wife, Joan. And then we have, of course, Bert Smith, who is a member of our community, and he is General Turnage's first cousin once removed, we decided. Then I want to recognize Bert, Bob, and myself as the committee who actually persevered for 2 years and got this marker here for us today. And lastly, but certainly not leastly, I want to recognize every one of you who came out to support and participate in this dedication and program. Thank you very much.
At first, it's a great day. If the general was here, and for the family, you know he is here today with us, he would be extremely proud. I mean, he would look over there and see young Marines over there. You see some aging Marines like myself here, and all the family and the local community come out, and I probably could not be more proud looking down on Farmville right now and saying, my goodness, all this over me, what's all the fuss? And that's okay. But the background and the setting for this couldn't be more fitting for something today. So just a few thank yous. Again, Congressman Jones, always great to see you here, and your support for Eastern North Carolina and Camp Lejeune in particular. We can never be thankful enough. My commanding general, Brigadier General Castelby, is in Iraq right now. He got pulled a year ago. He's still serving there, doing our country's work. And it's been trying for all of us, including him and his family. But he told me to give his regards this morning. And thank you. Mayor, of course, the attorney's family, elected officials, everybody's come. We did most of the thank yous. I don't want to offend anyone who listens, but thank you. I'm going to be pretty brief. I do want to point out how impressed it was that where the Marine Corps elite came from this morning. And I met detachment members coming all the way from Salisbury, which started driving at 6 o'clock in the morning. And that'll just show you, you know, that's what Marines do, but I think that's what people in North Carolina do. We'll get up and do the right thing. So without further ado, I'll make a few brief comments, and then we can move on.
Mayor Mason, Sergeant Major Berry, members of the Turnage family. For 80 years, the state of North Carolina, in a program co-sponsored by Archives and History and the Department of Transportation, has been erecting cast aluminum markers like the one we are gathered to get to dedicate today. Typically, these programs are, in one way or another, celebrations of a life, of a group, of an event. Approximately 1,500 of these markers now dot the state. In the recent past, we've dedicated markers to other military leaders, such as Frank Armstrong of Halifax County, who led bombing raids on Germany and chronicled his story in 12 o'clock high, and George Preddy, the flying ace from Greensboro. Other markers relate to the U.S. Marine Corps, including one near the entrance to Camp Lejeune, commemorating the training of African-American Marines at Montford Point. Many people associate our markers with the Civil War, and there are several hundred on that chapter of our history. But history does not stop there, and I'm pleased to say that this is our 25th marker concerning World War II. This is the 14th one in Pitt County, from George Washington's visit to the vicinity of Aden in 1791, to the Voice of America towers erected at the height of the Cold War. Our highway marker signs, manufactured in Ohio by the Siwa Studios, are made of cast aluminum, from ingots heated in a small furnace and poured into a mold using clay and a sort of a clamshell form. This is a process that goes back hundreds of years.
Congressman Jones, Mayor Mason, Mr. Cheering, Sergeant Major, friends, cousins, and taxpayers. That generally covers everybody I know in Congress. It is my very pleasant duty today to share with you some of my personal recollections and relationships with General Allen Hal Turnage and Hannah Pike Turnage, and to introduce our keynote speaker. Much of an invitation for our keynote speaker would be like my giving you a description of the town of Farmville by meets and bounds. He doesn't need it, but I'll give him a little. General Turnage's home is one block east of here. His church is there. Here in Farmville, if you mention the word Major, to most people it is well known that that is Major Benjamin May, who lived a mile west of here, and for whom the Major Benjamin May chapter of the Daughters of the American Revolution is named. If you mention BBT, some of you might think it's the bank just over there. To those of us who really know, it's Lieutenant Vernus Benjamin Turnage, United States Marine Corps, and a fighter pilot. If you mention General, it may be General Benjamin Otto Turnage, United States Army, or General Allen Hal Turnage, United States Marine Corps.
Honorable Judge Lewis, thank you for the words that you shared about the history of Farmville and the relationship with General Turnage and the family of General Turnage, and thank you for your kind introduction. I must say very quickly, this is my 10th year of trying to rename the Department of Navy Marine Corps, but John McCain just doesn't seem to have the same respect for the Marine Corps that I do, so he blocks it every year in the Senate. But if it's the Lord's will, we're going to get it done, whether I'm the one to score the touchdown from Marine Corps or someone else. It's the right thing to do. Much of the history of General Turnage has already been shared with you, and I am going to just share a couple of thoughts, and then I want to read the citation. General Turnage was awarded the Navy Cross. It's the second highest medal for valor that you can receive. And I think when you hear the citation, you will understand why the committee here decided that his service to our nation, being a native of Farmville, and should be remembered. And I want to thank the state of North Carolina for your program. I was very impressed, Mr. Cherry, to hear so many markers have gone up in North Carolina to honor the World War II as well as the wars before that in North Carolina. I say many times my biggest concern is that maybe the generation today and the next generation does not understand history as much as they should. So today is a historical moment for Farmville, and to the committee that worked hard on this to make this a reality, congratulations to each and every one of you for seeing the need and the proper respect for General Turnage. As a young man, I was not the best student, so for those of you who want to run for Congress and not the smartest guy in the world, look at me. You can make it. I had needed to be tutored by a lady named Annie Perkins, and only those of us who are past 60 will know that name. And she lived in the house that was known as the Turnage House on the second floor, and she tutored me in math because I was served in the Banana Wars, served in World War I, World War II, the Battle of Bougainville, the battle of several battles that go back to the World War II events of Guam. He was, as already been stated, that he was a Marine, quite frankly. I've never been a Marine, would not know what that means to the Marines, but when you say that about a general or a colonel or a non-commissioned officer, that he is a Marine, then that's something very special. And that's what I had always heard. The citation for the Navy Cross. The Navy Cross is presented to Allen H. Turnage, Major General, United States Marine Corps, for extraordinary heroism as Commanding General of the Landing Force of the 3rd Marine Division during the establishment of Beachhead in the Solomon Island area from November 1 to November 27th of 1943. Leading his command with daring aggressiveness, Major General frequently exposed himself to heavy enemy gunfire throughout the landing. Operations were central to the attainment and consolidation of the final beachhead line at Empress August Bay, Bougainville Island. His courage, distinguished leadership, and resolute devotion to duty throughout the period were an inspiration to the officers and men in his command, and in keeping with the highest tradition of the United States Naval Service. That in itself tells you why today is necessary, so that the service by General Hal Turnage, someone that will see this marker, maybe will go back, as I did, to research the history of his service to our nation. I believe I'm correct in saying that he became the first Assistant Commandant of the United States Marine Corps. There are Marines here today that can certainly correct me if I'm wrong. But I believe that is true, and I think that's one reason that the state of North Carolina decided that he had done so much as a Marine for our nation. And yet he came from a small town known as Farmville. Farmville, where many of us, including myself, were born here. Many here today have moved here. And it is a unique town with a unique people and a unique history. The Turnage family did so much to make Farmville what it is today. You know, to be a four-star Marine General is
not the ordinary. It is the exception. My staff in Washington found the orders of President Harry S. Truman. And I read, the President of the United States proudly authorizes the advance to General Allen, to General Hal Allen Turnage, the United States Marine Corps, for heroism in combat effective on his retirement date, 1 January 1948, signed by Harry S. Truman, President of the United States. In closing, I want to say that during Memorial Day, I rode through the cemetery here in Farmville, two of them, and at least two, and looked at the flags over the graves. Some of those men came home from the wars. Some did not. Across from my father and mother's grave here in Farmville, and one day would be my gravesite, was a young man named Paul Aaron Parker, who was 21 years old when he was shot down. I mention him because we're here today to honor General Turnage. That so many should never be forgotten. That's why Memorial Day is so special. And I thank the people of Farmville and the organizations that every year put the flags on the graves so that those of us who have the privilege to live, no matter if we're an elected official or just a citizen, to be reminded of the sacrifice. Today is the day of General Hal Turnage. I read the orders for the citation for the Navy Cross. He obviously was very deserving. So in closing, I want to thank the town of Farmville, the leadership of Farmville, the committee, and the Turnage family. You have done so much for Pitt County, Farmville, and Greenville, and other areas that you have moved and lived in. When we unveil this marker, it will be seen for hundreds of years to come. Somebody will say, I need to know more about General Turnage. And I thank God that we have the internet now that people can research and understand the pain of war, the commitment by so many of our men and women in uniform, and also the commitment of General Hal Turnage. So in closing, as I always do on the floor of the house, I still go to Walter Reed to see the broken bodies of Marines and Army. I didn't serve, but as a policymaker, I want to make sure that should we commit our young men and women to war, as we did in World War II, we had an end to the strategy. If you don't have an end to the strategy, then you have no plan to win the war. So I ask God to please bless our men and women in uniform. I ask God to please bless the families of our men and women in uniform. I ask God in His loving arms to hold the families who've given a child dying for freedom in Afghanistan and Iraq and all the wars that our nation has fought. And I ask God to please bless you and your families. I ask God to please bless America. We have issues facing our country, both morally and economically, that we need the guidance of God to resolve. I'll ask God to please bless the House and Senate, that we will do what is right in the eyes of God for God's people today and God's people tomorrow. I'll ask God to bless the President, that he will do what is right in the eyes of God for God's people today and God's people tomorrow. And I'll ask three times, God, please. God, please. God, please continue to bless America. Thank you very much.
Don't wait.
That's all right. Oh, there's one more person coming. Hold on. One more
person. Hey, you got that come up? Earl?
And then you, when they're up, Kevin, you can count them down to three.
Huh?
I will.
We'll give you a countdown. All the family members would like to come up.
Some of your cousins.
Come on up. All right. So, all the family members. Okay. So, what we're going to do is I'm going to give a 3-2-1, and on one, pull the front and let go of the back. Okay? 3-2-1. There we go.
Thank you.
Thank you. Remain standing just a minute and let us bow our heads in prayer. Thank you, God, for allowing us to have these fine Marine Corps troops attend our marker dedication today. Bless all our armed services veterans and all our service personnel protecting our interests all over the world. Amen. I just want to thank all of you for attending. We have cold water over here. Mingle in the shade and visit, and thank you for coming. God bless you all.